So Microsoft and LG have each come out with their own version of a dual screen Android device. They're actually similar in more ways than I thought. They both have a gap in the middle. You can close them to hide the displays. They're mainly focused on multitasking with apps launching on the screen you actually tap them on. Both approaches support app pairs as well as app spanning, or what LG calls wide view. They have similar dual screen modes like book mode, tent mode, tablet mode, laptop mode, and you can flip them back to act as regular-ish phones. Those things might make these two approaches look the same, and they might be at totally different price points, but the general experience on the Surface Duo is truly a different ballgame. If you like watching ballgames, let me tell you about our sponsor for this video, Zillion. This is a Zillion Shiatsu Back and Neck Massager. It's an affordable, portable massager that's perfect for the work-from-home reality that we're living in today. My work-from-home setup hasn't been the best since I recently moved, and to be honest, it's been taking a toll on my body. But this slim and compact massager has been doing wonders for the aching parts of my body during my work days. Since you can use the massager in so many different ways and on so many different parts on your body, it's great after work too. I've been using it for my back during gaming sessions and for my neck when I'm just laying down and checking my phone. It's also got a heating function to give you that extra bit of soothing and relaxation. If you need an affordable and convenient way to do some physical therapy at home, click the link below to get the Zillion massager now and make sure to use my promo code to get 15% off today. First off, you're dealing with two very different hardware approaches to dual screens. LG's dual screen is a detachable accessory, duplicating a tall modern phone display and adding a significant amount of thickness to the device. The accessory basically acts as a case and is mostly made of plastic. It really doesn't feel premium at all, especially with the uneven weight distribution between the two screens and the fairly flimsy hinge. But on the bright side, it is detachable, so it can be a good standard phone whenever you want it to be, and there's a small external display for notifications. The Surface Duo doesn't have an external display, and it can't be detached. But while LG's approach is phone first plus a dual screen accessory, the Surface Duo was designed from the start to be a native dual screen device. Opened and closed, the Duo is extremely slim. So slim that it's thinner than the gap between LG's dual screens. It's a premium all glass and aluminum design that feels incredibly good in the hand, especially when you open and close it, it's just such a satisfying feeling. This also because of the perfect symmetry of materials and weight between the two halves. And these are two 4x3 displays, which doesn't work well with some apps and might sound a little strange, but these short displays really help with the user experience. I'm able to reach all parts of the UI very easily, which I can't say the same for LG's tall 2x1 displays. This aspect ratio also helps for viewing content in all orientations, especially your landscape orientation and laptop mode. You can see so much more content, especially text-based ones, compared to LG's abnormally wide and short regular phone displays. I love using the Duo as a tiny laptop because I can actually see everything I'm typing vertically and horizontally. LG's laptop mode is pretty good too, but the super short and wide aspect ratio makes that a little awkward. Now, the Duo also has a gap in the middle, but it's much less noticeable than LG's approach and can actually still work for lots of things like browsing and some social apps. But yeah, viewing videos in tablet mode definitely does suck for both of these devices. The gap in hardware between these two devices is already pretty big, but the integration with the software widens that gap even more. So both these approaches treat each screen as a separate window. If you tap an app on a screen, it'll launch on that screen, and then you can open another app on the other screen. But the huge difference between these two is that LG literally treats each display as an entirely separate phone. The home screens are not connected, and you'll have to set up the additional screen from the ground up, including the app drawer. There's no way to import your main home screen setup to the dual screen. While this makes sense conceptually, since the dual screen can be for specific functions like checking the news, stocks, or whatever, but a lot of the times you want to open those things on the main screen, and if your home screen and app drawers are set up differently, you'll have to go digging around or search for a specific app, which is pretty inconvenient. That's why I chose to set them up exactly the same, but it's sort of a pain having to do this whole setup, especially for the app drawer. The Surface Duo is a much more cohesive experience. The home screen is still the same home screen, so you know where all your apps and widgets are and doesn't require separate setups for each screen. You launch an app and then you swipe over your familiar home screen to open another app, which just makes so much more sense for the user. If you get a notification, you can open it on any display, which isn't possible on LG as the additional screen has limited access to the notification bar. Another thing that makes more sense is the navigation gestures. LG uses regular Android 10 gestures along with this floating dual screen menu to manually control the second display. While I like that LG gives you the manual controls, the floating bubble is tiny and tricky to activate at times. LG does provide one useful gesture, and that's a 3-finger swipe to move an app to the other screen. But that's really the only one. The Surface Duo is almost entirely based on swipes and gestures. It's got those same Android 10 gestures as well, but that navigation bar is where everything happens. To move an app to the other screen, you just swipe on the bar towards that direction. Then if you want to span the app to use both displays, you just swipe up and move it towards the center. Not all apps take advantage of the dual screens, but you can span any app on the Duo. The ones that do take advantage, like productivity apps, are really great because you can view content without breaking your flow. This flow also works when you're not spanning. So if you click a link in your email, it'll open in a browser on the other display. You can do this on LG's phones as well, but it's not a native feature. You'll have to download this third-party app to make that work. Same goes for app spanning. While the Duo can span any app, LG has a very limited list of apps that can use its wide view feature. There is a third-party app that allows you to use wide view for any app, but unlike the Duo's dual screen optimized apps, no popular third-party apps are optimized for LG's dual screens. Microsoft Outlook sort of works, but it's more by accident. Overall, the Surface Duo just feels more fluid, and the software makes so much more sense for the user experience. With simple swipes and gestures, you're basically telling your apps where you want them to go. This makes everything easier from multitasking to laptop mode. The vision is definitely there, but as a lot of you might have heard, there are a lot of software bugs and those gestures can be unreliable at times. So it's actually nice that LG includes this dual screen menu for manual controls. On the Duo, you sometimes don't know which display will turn off if you flip it back, and this is a huge issue whenever I try to use a camera. The Duo gets confused which display I'm trying to use, and it can get really annoying, especially when you're trying to get a quick picture. Fortunately, LG's approach is a phone first, so you can activate the rear or front cameras without doing anything weird. Plus, with manual controls, you can fully control which display will turn off or not. In terms of the user's control over the dual screens, I'd actually say that the 2017 ZTE Axon M's simple nav bar did a better job than either of these phones. One thing LG gets a tiny win here is gaming. While Microsoft didn't do any optimizations for gaming on the Duo, LG lets you use the second display as a virtual controller. I said this is only a tiny win because the virtual controller's sensitivity is way off and is pretty bad in actual gameplay. All in all though, even with this known bugs and issues, the Surface Duo is a much more fleshed out version of a dual screen Android device. The combination of hardware and software feels much more thought out than LG's phone first, dual screen second approach. There's definitely still a learning curve when using the Duo, but it's a vision that will make sense to users when they actually use the device. Alright, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like the video if you did and subscribe to the channel for more Surface Duo videos. Let me know in the comments what else you'd like to see from the Duo and maybe it'll be my next video. Thanks again and I'll see you guys on the next one.